Try my best.
Thank you. Would you please stand?
Beloved in Christ,
Be at this Christmastide our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even to Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, and the babe lying in a manger. Therefore, let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience until the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill among all his people, for unity and fellowship within the church he came to build, and especially this community of Heathfield. And because this of all things would rejoice his heart, let us remember in his name the poor and helpless, the cold, the hungry, and the oppressed, the sick and those that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the young, all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. We commend all whom we love and all who need our prayers to the unfailing mercy of our Heavenly Father, in the words which Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Would you please be seated?
Oh,
kingdom are foretold by Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who have lived in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Thank you. Thank you. announce the birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. She gave birth to her firstborn son, then wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
The shepherds go to the manger. In that region, there were shepherds living in the field, keeping watch over their flock by Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favours." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us."
Treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. shepherds returned to glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
Observed his star at its rising, and have come to pay homage, pay him homage. When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him, and calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when he started. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage. When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and offered him in homage. And opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Great.
was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light, the true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came to being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his
glad of the yearly remembrance of the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that, as we joyfully receive him as our Redeemer, so we may, with sure confidence, behold him when he shall come to be our Judge, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. I would like to take this opportunity to say a huge thank you to our choristers and the organists, and also to all who have made this service possible, the church wardens and all their teams, the decorators and everyone else. I would just like, on all our behalf, to give them all a huge thank you. May he, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with the sweetness of inward peace and goodwill, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you and all those you love and pray for, this night and always. Amen. And I would also just like to wish you all a very happy Christmas when that season comes, a holy and happy time together. Amen.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Thank you.